These Easter rice pies are fresh out of the oven, and I'll show you how to make them. If you do decide to make them, there's two videos that you should watch first. One is the recipe for how to make the dough, and the other is the recipe for how to make the Italian cream, which is a component of this recipe. This is going to be the recipe for rice pie. I'm going to put the recipe on the screen. I have all my ingredients measured up, and then I'll show you how we're going to do the mix. I've placed everything into the bowl, including the Italian cream, and I'm just going to turn this machine on and start it mixing. So this is mixed. Before I take it off the machine, I have to scrape it down because some of the cheese or other ingredients are kind of stuck to the side of the bowl. This is a common practice that you have to do with all kinds of cake mixes. You have to just use your plastic scraper, scrape everything away from the side of the bowl, and then let it run just a little bit more. There we go, that's ready. Now, this is going to be rice pie. If you wanted to make wheat pies, you could substitute the cooked rice, and you could use cooked wheat or barley or any other kind of grain that you want to make your wheat pie with. Most people like the rice pie better, and that's what I'm going with here. So I'm rolling out the pie bottoms. This is the pie dough recipe for sweet Easter pies. I made a separate video to show you how to make this dough. I'm going to put a little bit of spray on these. A little bit of spray helps prevent those from helps prevent the dough from sticking to those. This dough is very tender, so you have to give it a lot of dust, and you have to go very gentle with it. You can't stretch it out too far. I like to roll it out like that. When it's almost the size of the pie pan, then I like to just take it onto the stick, roll it up like that, and then unroll it right into the pie pan. And then these will be ready to fill. All right, I've rolled out my pie bottoms, and now I'm going to pour the filling in. The filling that we made is enough for two pies. There we go, just right. All right, now that these pies are filled, I'm ready to top them off. I already started working on them. You have to take a little bit of egg wash and brush it around the perimeter. That'll help the cover to stick on top. I'm putting a solid cover on these with a little hole cut in the center from a small cookie cutter. If you wanted to do them with a lattice top, you certainly could. I just like to make these with a solid top. This dough is very tender. If it feels like you're having trouble rolling it out, you could always just take it and roll it back up with a little bit of extra flour, work a little bit of flour into it, and then it should make it easier for you to roll it out again. You also don't want to roll it too big. Just roll it almost just the right size of the pie. That's just almost exact same size of the pie. Cutting out a center. I'm going to take this dough and just gently roll it up onto this little pin. And then I'm going to take it and unravel it, unroll it right onto this pie. Now we're going to take these and just trim them off. So I move the pie over here, flatten down the edge a little bit, and just gently cut off the edges. Let me show you on the other one. I'll do that one more time. Save these scraps of dough. Those are good to work into the next batch of pie dough that you're going to use, especially if you're going to make some lattice top ones like a ricotta pie with the lattice top ones. That extra trimmings helps that dough for the lattice hold together a little bit better. So those are ready. Now I have to brush the top of these with egg. So I have my egg wash. Just going to brush these up. I have my oven preheating at 350, and I'm going to put these right into the oven. And those are ready to go. I have my oven preheated at 350, and I'm ready to put these in. I'm estimating that these are going to bake between 30 and 40 minutes. So I'm going to set my timer for 30 minutes, and I'll come back and check them. It's been 30 minutes. These are browning up nice, but I could tell that they're not ready yet because if I shake the tray, I could see that they still jiggle. So I'm guessing that these are going to probably need another 10 to 15 minutes. So I'll set the timer and we'll be back. It's been an additional 14 minutes, and these are now ready. I could tell because they look like they're inflated. You could see that they're puffed up a little bit higher than they were before, and the centers are a little firmer. They don't jiggle quite as much, so I'm going to take these out. And there you go. Rice pies. Those are ready. These have to cool thoroughly before you cut them, so I'd let them cool for several hours, even refrigerate them overnight before you try to serve them.